We do also have this week going on the DC Fandom, which is going to be a huge streaming event that people can watch. And a lot of people have asked us if we're going to be covering. I think it's on Saturday. It's a very long stream on Saturday. I don't think we're going to be like watching it live or anything like that. But anytime there's any like big news or a trailer or something like that, we'll either do like a reaction to it or we can talk about like next week's podcast or something like that. But there was, you guys want some breaking DC news? It's pretty interesting to me.
Sure.
Aaron, you might like this.
Is it what got tagged in Twitch chat just now?
Oh, I'm not.
Go ahead and say it.
News! Ben Affleck will return as Batman in The Flash. The Flash being a movie that, good luck.
So they're still going to make The Flash movie?
They've been trying to make that movie for a very long time. But, I mean, they were just talking about other Batman characters being in these movies. But, actors, but Ben Affleck returning in The Flash. This is really interesting to me because we also have the Snyder Cut coming up, which, you know.
Well, not only that, but we have a new Batman, too.
So we have
two Batman,
Batman
at the same time.
Which they also released a new logo for the Batman.
I saw
and
that.
A Jim Lee illustration, which was really awesome. But, yeah, Ben Affleck returns.
Yeah, I like Ben Affleck as Batman. I thought he did a good job, and I would have loved to have seen more from him.
Yeah.
But then all we got was Justice League.
Yeah.
And a little bit of like, here's a clip here, here's a clip there, and the Batman v Superman thing, you know?
Yeah.
Like, and that was it.
And I wanted to see him at all. I heard that he's like an amazing Bruce Wayne and a pretty good Batman.
I think fun. Aesthetically, he's the best Batman that's ever been put to film. He looks the part. I love the way that he performs Bruce Wayne, and I love the way he performs Batman. I just think that not all the choices were necessarily great made with him. Though I loved Snyder's consistency, and I hated Whedon's quippiness, you know?
Yeah,
I don't think
Batman.
It works for Batman.
Yeah, sure. Batman shouldn't be quippy.
He shouldn't. Some of the conversations that he had with Ezra Miller as a Flash just weren't super exciting to me.
Batman should be slightly quippy.
Yeah.
Like, he's had quips as Kevin Conroy.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, he's had some quips in there. Like,
sure.
I think you can fit him in, but he shouldn't be Spider-Man quippy.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean
I love the way he filled that suit.
Yeah.
I love the way he looked in his suit. Like, it was so good.
Yeah,
him as Bruce Wayne was fine. I had no problem with that.
Is Ezra Miller still going to be the Flash?
I believe so.
Okay. I know that there was the incident in, was it Canada, at a bar or something like that?
Slap somebody.
Yeah, like he hit it or hit her, choked her. I forget what it was, but yeah there was. There was some stuff on there, and I wasn't sure what they were going
to
do with that.
No, I try not to look up too much, but yeah, I've seen like Ezra Miller and Jared Leto stuff being like, what the fuck are these guys doing? But anyway, I mean, I think that Ben Affleck, they only scratched the surface of what they were able to do with something like that. But, I mean, with Michael Keaton, Ben Affleck, we can get some Val Kilmer in there somehow, you know. Clooney, no. I'd take Kilmer over Clooney.
Why wouldn't you?
I don't know.
Why would you ever put Clooney above Kilmer?
He's got the bat card.
Well,
never leave the cave without it.
I mean, Clooney's in better shape than Val Kilmer.
Well, yes. How come Irish Struck?
I thought he got in shape for Top Gun.
I don't think he's in it.
Did that Top Gun movie come out yet?
I don't know.
It probably didn't because of...
I don't remember.
It hasn't come out.